something. I don't know. Hi, remember me. I'm Jen. I'm from the Sticks and Threads podcast. I'm living here with my husband, my three children, our cat, and a dog. Yes, we got a dog. It's been over a year since I recorded my last episode, and just it wasn't happening. A lot of things happened. Family changed, life changed, stuff happened, life happened. It just didn't work out. But today I decided it was time again to try. My last episode had sound issues and I was terribly sorry about that. I don't know if it's better this time. If it is, yay. If it's not, I'm sorry. I don't know how to fix it. And it's what it is. I don't know anything about recording issues and microphones. I have a microphone here, but I have no clue if it's working. So I'm just gonna go with the flow. And I'm sorry if it's not a good sound. Also, the lighting is really terrible because I'm sitting in front of a window and I had to close the blinds because the sun decided to shine today. All days it's raining and today it's shining brightly. It's what it is. We're just gonna take it. So, hi. It's been a very long time. A lot has changed, but I'm still me and I'm still a knitting addict, a yarn addict, and enjoying knitting and yarn as much as I can. I'm not gonna show you all my finished objects from last year. I have shown them on Instagram and some even have not been shown yet, but I'm not going to go over it. I don't want to. It will take way too long. So I'm just gonna jump in with my works in progress and just chat about my knitting because that's what I love. I will start with this. This lives in my purse. It's my vanilla sock. This lovely, lovely bag is made by Jimmy Roo Sews and it reminded me of Edinburgh. I don't know. I'm sorry if I mispronounce anything. I love this bag. It's the perfect size. When I ordered it, I thought it was like a pencil case because I needed a pencil case. But it's big enough to hold a project, a vanilla sock. My son asked me if I wanted to knit him socks. He just loves hand-knitted socks and he even raided my sock basket because he just wanted hand-knitted socks. They are way too big for him. He's 8 years old. He has a size 31, a European size. Needle cozy. I really love needle cozies. It's by Nedo Mikado. It's from Germany. And I had won this in a giveaway and I love using it because this is living in my purse. I need to protect my needles. This is my sock. It's only the first one. And I just enjoy knitting when I'm out and I have a chance to do a few stitches. Progress keeper or stitch marker. I don't know what you want to call it. Is from Starfiber Studio on Etsy, Esther. She makes these and I really love her stitch markers. And the yarn, of course, is Regia, especially for kids. My son picked this out and he is asking me every day, are my socks ready yet? No, they live in my purse. And then he just says, well, go out more often because you need to knit on them. So I might change this out and just put it next to my chair downstairs and knit more often on it and just use another vanilla sock. I might do that. I really love knitting with regia yarn and opal yarn because they're nice and sturdy sock yarn, and I know where his feet go, so he needs sturdy sock yarn, and this bag is really lovely. Check the sizes when you go to her Etsy shop from Jibiru, because you might get a surprise. The other one, I had ordered a pink one as well, and it's just so big, and I was really thinking it was a needle case or a pencil case, but it was, well, 3 times as big, so I should have checked on sizes. She makes awesome bags for really great prices. That's one. I have 4 more works in progress. I didn't know I had that many, but I had a huge basket full of whips and everything, and it was just overwhelming me, and I really pushed it, and I frogged a few things, and I was like, no, I'm never gonna wear that, I'm never gonna use that, it's the wrong size or anything like that. And I just frogged it and put it away, and I was like, no, it's done. And now I only have 4 whips that are active, and I have 2 whips in the basket left because 2 sweaters, and I'm not knitting on those right now, so I'm not going to show you. Next up, there's dog hair all over my stuff, is another sock living in this so adorable bag by My Cottage number 9. I really love this bag. It's so cute. It's the perfect size for your sock knitting, or maybe a hat or a pair of mittens, but it's just perfect, really. I have no needle cozy on this one. Why didn't I do that? It's a sock, of course, and it's a very easy pattern. I have the heel in. It's a pattern by Mina Philip Knitting Expert, and it is the Driftwood socks. I have a huge collection of sock patterns, and I just need to work those up. I'm going to try to knit as much from stash as possible, because it's, as you can see, this is sock yarn. It's too much. But the yarn I'm using is by Lochbrier Knits from Canada. September morning. And this is the cake. And I just really, I love these colors. It's BFL, and I still love BFL. I decided I don't really like high twist yarn anymore because it hurts my hands a little bit. But this is from stash, and I want to knit from stash, and I love these colors, so it's really, this is her tag. She was my fiber share partner from 2 years ago. Has it been 2 years? I don't know. I think I bought these because I fell in love with the yarn. I am saving so many skein, as you can see, and I'm like, no, they're too pretty, they're so pretty, they need to stay in the skein. I'm like, right now, I'm like, but I need to knit them up. I need to use the finished item. And then I think, well, what if I don't like the finished item, and I will not wear it, and like, but it's not useful being in the skein either. It looks pretty, but I need to knit it up. So I'm really trying to do that. I was on a no buying any more yarn because I have yarn. But I messed up this Sunday, and I just could not resist. And I just used the excuse I helped 2 friends. I supported 2 lovely indie dyers, and that's my excuse. I'm just gonna stick with it. Forgive me. Next, we you've seen the socks. I will switch it up a little bit. I have this gorgeous pink hazel bag. She really makes stunning bags and I just love this one. I love it. It's fully stuffed. It has a lot of things in it. And when you hear what I'm knitting on, you're like, you don't need all that. Like, can you see? I have DPNs, a lot of mini skeins and yarn. I'm knitting a gnome. Let me get it out. I'm really out of practice. I'm really sorry. Where is the... I don't have the front sheet, I think. The pattern is gnome is where you hang your hat. I cannot show this form because it has the pattern on it. I'm way behind on... Gnome is where you hang your head. From Imagine the Landscapes, Sarah Shira. I hope I pronounced it correctly. And she makes lovely, cute gnomes, and I really enjoy knitting those. This is how far I am. I'm way behind. I think I'm on. I love it. I can't wait to have it finished. I need to knit on it, but yeah, time. So that's the body, and I'm knitting them on DPNs Knit Pro 2.25. I really have gotten the hang of knitting with DPNs. That's the dog. I think he hears the cat. Because the cat enjoys peeking downstairs and just letting the dog know she's there and he can't get to her. These are my colors. It's mini skeins from Giddy Yarns. She dyes amazing yarns. Really, I kind of have a crush on her yarns. It's from Winnie the Pooh collection. I have more mini skeins from her right here. Like, it was so difficult to choose, and I know the contrast is really low. Like, you can't really, it could be more visible, but I just wanted to use this. I had bought them specifically for this pattern, and I just had to use them. Next is a sock in this lovely wintry bag because I really miss winter. It's hardly any winter here and I really miss winter. So I decided it's totally fine to use this bag. It's not a Christmas bag, it's a wintry bag, and it's by Duckpool Lane. Normally I'm not a zipper bag person, but I like this zipper. It's nice and sturdy and it's not catchy at all. It's well made and I just love this pattern. And also, to be honest, I went for the drawstring when she had it in the shop in December, I think, but it sold out before I could get to check it out. So I decided I'm going for the zipper, and I don't regret it. I'm knitting on a sock. I decided to join the Handmade Sock Society number 3 from Helen Stewart, Curious Handmade, and I am trying to find, I don't have the front page. I am sorry. I don't have it. I can show you this. Luminary socks. And I decided since I have this much sock yarn, I need to join it because I need to knit up all the socks. Where is my tag? Ah, it's still in my ziplock. Sorry. This is also, I'm using giddy yarns. It's giddy yarns, and the colorway is Green Eyed Monster. And she gifted me this yarn in Get Your Yarn Wish Granted, I think also 2 years ago. She was 2 or 3 years ago. I don't know. It's been sitting here for a very long time, and I just no longer wanted it to sit around, be pretty. I tried to design a sock pattern with it, but I need more time for that to learn and think about it. Also, Needle Cozy, it's by the Purple Lady. She no longer has her shop, so I'm really glad I have this one. I really love Needle Cozy. And this is it knitted up. And I really love it. The Progress Creeper is by Maak het Effe. It's on Etsy. And she really makes their small beads. I hope you can see it. And it's so cute. I really love it. I wanted to buy more of it. I don't need more, and I'm really trying, like, no, I don't need it. I want it. I want it all, but I don't need it. So I'm trying to resist. It's just a matter of time before I cave. So really, really cute. I really love this sock pattern. So this is the second sock. This is the kick. It's really lovely shades of green, and I really enjoy it. When I cast on, I thought, might not work with this pattern. I don't know, I'm not sure. Let's just see what happens. And before I knew it, I had one sock finished, and I was like, ah, it works. It's nice. Okay, I'm just gonna keep going, because I'm not gonna frog an entire sock. And I really like it. Like, this is the sock finished. I don't have my sock blockers right here, and I don't want to get up and find them. Like, it's so cute. I love it. And it's knitting up really fast, faster than I thought it would. And it's really a joy to work on. And it's one. I need some water. I have my mug here. The ones I collect are downstairs on the wall, looking pretty. And this one I can get easily, so I'm not afraid of using it. Like, I'm not using my Australia mug or my South Africa mug, because it's not easy to get those. I collect these Starbucks mugs, and I really love how they feel and use and everything. So that last project, it's a massive one, and it's been haunting me for a very long time. I am using this bag, Jibby Russo's, and it's just, it just had, I had to have it. It's this big wave. It's, yeah, my husband works at sea. So he's away for 6 weeks and home for 5 weeks approximately. And we have something with the ocean. I worked at an office that did all kinds of loads for shipping, and I started out with my love for the ocean, and I just had to have this bag. In it is a sweater for my husband, well, not the sweater yet, but I'm trying to knit up a sweater for my husband. About 2 years ago, he said, "I want a sweater. I want you to knit me a sweater. Can you please knit me a sweater?" And I said, "Well, okay. What do you want?" And he said, "I want cables. I love cables. I want cables." Okay. So I just looked up a few and took a Sorry. That freaked me out. 1 second. I looked up some sweater, men's sweaters with cables, and took some screenshots and showed them to the husband and let him pick. He picked the one with overall massive cables, and it was, I said, okay, that's what you want. I can do that. I will do that. No problem. I got the book with the pattern in it, and I started swatching and everything, and I started, and I regretted it instantly. Like, no, it was so much work, and it was so heavy on my mind. I really had to sit at a table and work with the pattern stitch by stitch. It took me about 45 minutes to do one row. So I had already said to him, I'm only doing the cables on the front, I'm not doing them on the back, I'm not doing them on the sleeves, this is it. But one row took me 45 minutes, and I just put it in a corner and like, no, I can't deal with this. I can't deal with it. This is too much. I can't deal with it. But he kept asking me, where's my sweater? Where's my sweater? I want my sweater. When can I have my sweater? So I said to him, well, you're never ever going to get that cabled sweater. I can't do it. Not now. And it will probably never happen. If you want a sweater, it will be a plain stockinette sweater. He was sad, but I said, it's that or nothing. And so he said, okay, just a plain stockinette sweater. It is. So I found this pattern, the Hans Holm sweater by Petite Knit, and it's really a plain stockinette sweater, round and round, and but again, it's a drag. It's so boring. From one end, it's so heavy on your mind, till the boring end. Just so boring, but I'm plowing through, as you can see. I think I'm halfway. It's really massive, but I work on it at night when the kids are in bed and I'm tired from the day, and just crash on the sofa, and like I have about 1 hour before I have to walk the dog, and I just fall asleep if I don't. So I have about 1 hour, and then it's just plain stockinette round and round, and it's what's working the best at the moment. I'm alternating skeins. These are really messy at the moment. Where is the tag? I am using the Cascade 220 headers, and I enjoy knitting with it. It's a nice yarn. He had chosen this yarn for the cabled sweater, so this was the yarn I am using for the nice and easy sweater. Really, these are by Coco Knits. Stitch Stoppers. And they are really good. These, I don't know where this one came from. I think it was a gift, but I cannot remember, and I'm sorry. you remember them, please let me know, because I'd like to thank you again for these lovely stitch markers. So it's really a plain sweater for him, and I really hope he will wear it and likes it. And yeah, I stopped bugging me about his sweater, because that's all he does. Have you knit my sweater yet? Is it finished yet? You're knitting so much. Why is my finished? Is my sweater not finished yet? Yeah, so I am working on it every day to get it finished for him. And I hope it fits, and I hope he likes it. If not, it's done. I will stick to knitting socks for him, because he enjoys wearing his hand-knitted socks, and he really wants more. But I want to knit all the socks for me. Duh. Yeah, so, those are all the works in progress. I do not have any more finished objects to show you. I don't know what else to show you. I don't have any acquisitions to show you. Because this is just a new start. Yeah, I think that's about it. Life, I don't have much to mention. We enjoy living here in the north of the Netherlands. It was the best decision we ever made. I'm not going to make any promises on when the next episode will happen. I'm just going to see what will happen. If even this goes up, I'm not sure if I have the guts to do it. I have to start editing, and the minute I start editing, I'm like, oh, that sounds horrible. Oh, you should have said that. Oh no, that's horrible. I don't know if I dare to put it up, but we'll see what happens. Just be kind. If I do put it up, just be kind. It's really scary to record and put it up on the internet and put yourself out there. It's really scary. And so I'm going to leave it here. I'm going to walk the dog and then try to edit it and upload it before I really chicken out. And on that, I am going to say goodbye. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope to talk to you again soon. Bye.